I think Charlie's just essentially a part of me that is hidden away. It's like the social anxiety part of me that I've always had, that I've taught myself out of. Yeah, it was just me as a young teenager, essentially, I think Charlie was. I love him to bits. He's a nutcase. And however morally grey you think he might be.
How do you feel about the way Charlie is towards the end of the season? Do you not dislike, you know, how he becomes?
No, I don't think he's got a choice, really. He's got to step up and do make the decision that no one else can. I love Charlie to bits, and however, yeah, as I say, however morally grey he is, he's good at heart. So, yeah, I love him. It was pretty mental getting to know that we were going to film with the Doctor. I mean, we'd kind of hoped it was going to happen, but we weren't sure. But yeah, that was a real honour for us, and yeah, I lost it a little bit when I found out. And to actually work with him was incredible. He's I've never heard a bad word said against him, really, and I think that's a testament to how wonderful he is as an actor and as a person. He takes the time to get to know you, so he knows your name, make sure you're okay. He's amazing on set. It's, watching him work is a real joy. It was wonderful.
I remember when we was on set that day, you know, we was told that, you know, Peter Capaldi was going to be on set, and we all had to act like we wasn't going to be starstruck. And I remember meeting him and having to act composed, you know, like this is a normal day for me. But he was honestly the nicest man. I remember him coming up to me and asking me how I was, and the conversation didn't end there. You know, he'll want to find out more about me and where I've come from and how I'm going to act in. And I really respected that about him, you know, for to be such a huge role model and still take the time out to, you know, care about how people are. I found really, really special about him. And honestly, he's the pleasurable person to work with. To watch him work, I'm sure we learned so much as well. So it was just a pleasure to be a part of, you know.
I like to see Captain Jack. I think having a bit of a John Barrowman would be really cool, just because that's just like a bit of a fantasy casting, just to have that come back in. And I don't know, have that launch another series of Torchwood would be fun, alongside Glass would be really cool. Something like that would be really cool for me. I think I nicked a sonic screwdriver. Don't think they know about that.
There's
a few of them lying around, so I was like, I'll have that. And things like call sheets and stuff. But none of the big stuff. Maybe next series, we need to go up our stealing game. Yeah, let's get a Dalek. We dismantle it.
We could actually got a Dalek.
Each day, get a little bit more out.
Yeah.
Let's do it. It was really nerve-wracking, I think, when we got the roles, and when the announcement was about to go out, we were really worried that people were going to instantly dislike it, because it's the Doctor Who fan base is so dedicated and so so dedicated to the show, that to give a bit of that away is like handing over your baby. It really meant a lot to have the response from the fans, and we really do appreciate it. Patrick hadn't told us anything about what was going to happen at the end of the series, so the big plot twist at the end is pretty surprising for us too, and we lost it a little bit.
Yeah, no, we definitely did. I remember I got in trouble as well, because there was like I said, we filmed next to the Doctor Who props cupboard, and there was like Daleks and Weeping Angels, and they've been there since the beginning of filming.
Only Fady would do this.
For some reason, I decided to take a picture of the Weeping Angel, and 5 minutes later, while we was filming episode 6, Derek's pulled me. He's like, what have you done? The Radio Times have posted about you. I swear to God, it was 5 minutes. The Radio Times are like, oh, are the Weeping Angels coming back to class, blah, blah, blah. And I got in so much trouble, but I genuinely had no idea that they were going to be coming back. And the day that I decided to take a picture of a Weeping Angel is the day that we get the script. So, yeah, I just take selfies with everything and I get in trouble.